Yeah, hi everyone. So last week we learned about autoencoders. Autoencoders are special types of neural networks that consists of two parts, an encoder that takes an input and decompresses it into a smaller dimensional representation, and the decoder which takes the smaller dimensional representation and reconstructs the input. I showed you then an example where I was drawing a random coordinate from this lower dimensional space, and I was using the decoder to create a new image that is somewhat similar to the training data. So in that way, we can think of it as generating new data. However, when we talk about higher dimensional spaces, so if the lower dimensional space is more, let's say, than more than two dimensions, this method doesn't work very well because there are several challenges with that. I will go into more detail about that in this lecture. So in this lecture overall, I want to talk about a particular type of autoencoder called the variational autoencoder. And this variational autoencoder is better for sampling new data. So you can think of the variational autoencoder as a generative model that we can use to sample from a distribution and generate new data. So in that way, it's kind of like a modified version of that autoencoder, particularly well suited for creating new data. And before I go into too much detail about how that works, let me give you the lecture overview, and then we will learn step by step how this variational autoencoder works. And I will show you also, of course, some code examples. Again, the MNIST code example, but also more interestingly, we will take a look at a data set consisting of face images, and then we will also learn how we can make people smile. All right, let's get started. All right, so these are our topics for today. And really, don't worry, I know it looks like a lot, 8 topics, but I'm really keeping it short this time. I know that our lecture days are limited, there are only a few days left in the semester, and you are all busy with working on your class projects and other classes as well, I'm aware of that. So I don't want to make things too complicated at the end of the semester and just give you a big picture overview of what a variational autoencoder is here. And I only made 25 slides. I'm very confident that I'm going to be able to finish this lecture within our regular 75-minute lecture time. And I also have code examples, of course. So with that lecture here, I'm hoping to give you a big picture overview of how a variational autoencoder works. And I will also provide you then with some future references if you're interested, because there's also a lot of mathematical underpinnings behind variational autoencoders, which we can't cover here in this lecture, but some of you may be interested in that, so I will also provide further studying resources. All right, so in the next video, we will start with the overview of what a variational autoencoder is.